Hello, fans of Mayhem and Magic. How are you doing today? Have you finished your quilts yet? I know you've been busy. What was that all about? They gave him like some sort of weird skin. I thought he was going to look like that. When they magicked him, I thought he'd be like this weird monster with patchy skin, you know? But he just turned into a normal dude. He should have accepted that deal, you know? He was a smoke man before that. He got too greedy. I want the power of three. He got even more greedy, actually. Not only did he want the power of three, then he wanted Aunt Gail to stay around and help him get the... What was he doing? Making people young? Getting their souls? Something like that? He just wanted it all. He wanted his cake. He wanted his youth. He wanted his power. And he went to the one place where he saw a vision of him losing all that. He was stupid. The one thing he didn't wish for, a brain. What was the moral of The Wizard of Oz? Something about it was inside you all along? Anyway, that guy was the Scarecrow, is what I'm saying. Piper has doubts about this whole being a good witch thing. She's just kind of a bit tired of it at the moment. We'll see if that is something that sticks around for a while. Leo's got his wings back, so she's can't be too happy about that either. Prue's still... And Phoebe's still doing her psych stuff. So I'm looking forward to this one. This one is called Chick Flick. So they're all just going to be sitting around watching the TV. My favourite object in the house. So let's get into it. Nope. Is she going to see something in these pictures?
I was watching Dan come home alone, and he was a nice guy who did nothing wrong, and...
Yeah, but...
Piper, you had to end the relationship, all right? Your heart wasn't in it. Besides, you shouldn't be worried about your past when your future is in town tonight for dinner and a movie.
Oh.
My first real date with Leo as a normal couple.
Dinner and a movie?
And normal couples usually shower before their date, so I'll see you later.
Get up there.
Okay.
Hi, Doody.
Hi, Doody.
Someone's in a good mood. What's his name?
Billy.
What?
I mean, if I'm supposed to figure out what I want from a guy, I might as well start with the first guy I fell for, don't you think? Billy is the ideal man.
Oh.
He's a character in a movie.
Oh. Who is this Billy? Is he going to come to life through this, through the TV, through the movie screen? What the hell? Who is this guy? Are you Billy?
And then there were two.
You okay?
Then there were two?
Come on, come on.
What the hell just happened? Were you paying attention? He's gone back into the movie screen.
I hope
he's gotta be hiding in here somewhere.
Excuse me, but do you think he might keep it down?
Dude, did you see a guy?
He's making a break for it. Evil that has traveled near, I call on you to disappear. Hear my call. Remove this creature from these walls.
Send him
that was the coolest thing I've ever seen.
Into the movie?
It's all part of the show, sir. It seemed too easy.
What's going on?
We're getting way too tough for these guys.
Oh, he's in the movie! I am human and I need to be loved. What happened there? She opened the door, she got flung across. This demon comes out of nowhere. He's not Billy. Then they go chasing him and they send him into the movie. They don't know that, but is he just going to be in that movie or is he going to be in all movies? Oh, it was so sudden though. It just came out of nowhere. They, you know, rapid pace. Even Piper didn't know what was going on. Now, what was Undead Door 2 about? What was that about? Phoebe didn't get killed or anything.
How am I supposed to know
out what his deal is.
Leo! Piper, go get ready.
How come we can't fight the demon of cleanliness, or the demon of housekeeping, or even that really big bald guy, Mr. Clean? I would so totally take him on.
I knew I recognized him from somewhere. He was at the movies, and then he followed me home.
You have one message.
Oh my god, I'm late. I'm so late.
Go.
Hold this. I'll help when I come back, but Leo's been
waiting. Go!
Hey Leo, do you know what's going on in this episode?
How's the date so far?
So I'm dressed up.
It just got better.
I'm sorry.
It's alright, you're here now.
Yeah, everything's fine.
Demon or something burst into the house and somehow Phoebe managed to vanquish him, but something just feels off.
Yeah, something...
I'm sorry, no work talk, we promised.
I feel off.
There's no salt. Could you ask that table for theirs?
Excuse me, may we borrow your salt?
Oh, shit's done. What are the odds?
Hi, Dan. And Dan's date.
Amelia, this is Leo and Piper.
We're not allowed to hate Amelia?
Amelia as in someone I just work with, Amelia?
Oh, shit. Amelia. You bitch. we should go somewhere else.
Is this some kind of a test?
Oh, she's getting good at this.
There's only so much a girl can take.
Let's get out of here.
Here's to our first real date.
Oh, in peace. Oh, he's been called. He's been called away.
They need you?
Could you freeze them?
I just wanted tonight to be perfect.
Well, it was.
Yeah.
I was with you.
See? Oh, he's a charmer.
Talk to anyone who was in the movie theater at the time. We'll find out what happened before the fight broke out.
That was her boss. A fight at the movie theater.
Finley's running late to the interview, so you're gonna have to shoot him before.
As in Finley Beck?
Super famous Finley Beck.
I thought you were just a beginner.
Not only is he a gifted photographer, but he just seems so giving and warm. Yeah.
Finn. Lazy excuses, and you can tell him I said so.
There he is. Really great guy.
I'm Mr. Beck. I'm Prue Halliwell.
Tell me you're not planning on shooting me in
with
digital.
This?
Oh, no. Digital is for amateurs. Careful, dear. Your true colors are showing. Get me some tea.
Dude, never meet your heroes.
Oh, here I am talking about the shortage of perfect men and in orbs yours.
Fortunately, I'm here to talk about the bad guys.
Is this about the guy in the movie?
Gets the demon of...
illusion. Apparently, he uses magic to create violence in society. He's got a scar below his eye.
And a goatee?
Yeah, but we got rid of him.
We vanquished him last night.
Into the movie.
Unless the demon isn't gone.
It was just too easy. That vanquishing spell didn't work.
Billy! Up on the screen.
Actually, I was just leaving.
Oh, you can't get him.
Tricks are for kids.
Piper.
Sally Mae, where are you?
He's gonna kill Billy.
I thought you said you weren't gonna cause any...
Shut up!
Hey!
Oliver.
Oh my god, I think he's looking at me.
Intense stare.
Dampering a little love connection here, sis, but we need to kick some ass.
Are you just gonna flirt me to death like your little tarty sister?
What?
Watch your language in front of the ladies. Consider that a warning.
Really? Phoebe likes that guy? Billy's in the real world.
Stop him!
Oh, he's black and white.
How did you... Thanks for the inspiration, sport.
What? Even he's confused. Isn't he the illusionist guy? Hey. Well, Phoebe, how'd you like him now?
But is there a point in this scene where someone explains my part to me?
You just stand there?
Billy, this isn't a movie. We are all real, and you... I haven't quite figured that part out yet.
They're the good guys.
Yeah, right. we're the good guys.
Leo, they told you that his goal was to create violence in society?
But they left out the how part.
He goes into movies. That's where he does it. Where's the music?
Music?
This is around the second act, right? When everything's about to be explained? Where's the music we're supposed to talk over to build suspense and hide the exposition?
Yeah, could we...
Don't you just hate exposition?
Yeah.
Don't even get me started.
The audience. When they leave, they're angry.
That's why there was a fight. We heard about that earlier.
All right, so he'll be in horror movies. I'll grab a paper, head out to the theaters that are playing those. Do something with Billy, you know, add a little
technicolor to him.
Does that wash off your black and whiteness?
Hello?
Miss Halliwell.
Mr. Beck.
Oh shit, this guy. Just getting a new camera.
I want to see them.
Now?
Yes.
Well, no, see, actually...
Something's never changed for Prue. Right
now. We can meet at the magazine later.
Who's out there?
Well, when would be good for you, exactly?
Now.
He's right there.
I can see you moving.
Hey.
Darkroom would be where?
Don't mind me. I'm just wandering through your house.
What are we watching? I don't recognize this one. Is it Axeman? The Axorcist? You got her, dude.
How'd you like to do that for real?
Oh, he's bringing him out.
Who needs violence when you can make it yourself?
Oh, are they going to start fighting?
Say that to me.
Yeah, I said whatever.
What did you just say to me?
It's your living room. You want a piece of me?
Oh, take this popcorn, dude.
And then that part when Sally Mae gets her hair caught in the car door. I love that part. I'm sorry. You've lived it.
It's all right. I like to hear what you think.
Aw. Okay. Don't fall for this guy. He's just empty on the inside. Look at him.
You make me feel like a kid again.
Cupid, could you get in here?
That's how it was written. I don't exist outside that movie.
Right.
Until now.
Yeah, how do you know what to say right now?
I think you're swell, Phoebe.
Oh, swell. That's going to get our butterflies.
Thank you, Billy.
Thumping?
I don't know how this happened.
You're in my world now. What do you want to do?
Oh, jeepers. Ooh, first base.
Hello.
Hi, Phoebe. Thanks for the heads up.
Hey, dude.
One dead, four injured.
Oh, somebody died?
I think this day's gonna get worse before it gets better, okay? All right.
Yeah, bye. Keep an eye out for axe murderers. What do you think, dude?
Not really a good time. I really need to demonstrate something for you.
Demonstrate.
Once you finish. Sisters.
Wait, where is this dark room? In their house?
Would you like me to hold your hand this time?
Oh my god.
I figured out what's wrong with your photos, Miss Halliwell.
Is it you, your face?
Absolutely no depth.
Just like your character?
Now, would that be the technique or the subject?
Yes! Yes!
Devastating to me to realize that the brilliance of your eye is completely destroyed by the ignorance of your mouth.
Ooh. What do you think, dude? Do you respect her now? Is she burning everything?
If you leave your subject under the light too long, they burn.
Oh. Get out of our basement. She's a scary one. Don't take her out. She's too scary.
Mary!
Mary!
Oh, bloody Mary!
Oh, jeez. Please don't.
There's one of the girls who's been getting in my way.
Oh, I can't stop her. Get out of here. Leo!
Okay, let's go.
Sparkles. Can he only do the sparkles at certain times? Get us out of here, Leo. Oh, axe guy! We have to kill the illusionist guy? And they all disappear? Including Phoebe's Billy? It was a nice one shot of her running through the house.
Hello, privacy.
Hello, axe murderer.
Billy, save us.
Where is everybody?
Oh, upstairs.
Sneaky, sis.
We should have to physically kill them.
He sent some white pasty hag literally off of the screen to kill us. Oh. I think he called her Bloody Mary.
We should chop her head off.
He's from Axe Husband. I saw that last week.
Axe Husband. Oh, he's not dead.
We can't kill them. They're not real. They're fiction.
Can they kill each other?
Billy.
No, Billy.
I have something in common with the bad guys.
Oh, he can't die. That's not gonna... Why are you in here?
I'm being stalked by psycho killers and I hide in the shower.
Oh, shit. Maybe it's a nice person. Maybe it's Leo.
Pretty little girl.
Throw her out the window. What's the plan?
So maybe this is the only way that the psychos know how to die is how they were killed on screen.
Oh. How did you die in your movie?
Me. And she was thrown out of a window.
Yeah.
And
oh.
That axe guy, he was electrocuted. So, okay, get her.
Out the window.
We have got to do something.
I can't believe that was right. Yeah. Nice, it worked.
Does anybody else get tired of cleaning up after these guys?
Oh, do we have a toaster or something? Okay, it's a mop. We got some water. Oh, a heater. Got him. What do we do with Billy? Who's at the door? Did he get somebody else? Is it Dan? Is it Daryl? Is it the photography guy?
It's Daryl.
Oh, it's Daryl.
Hi. Serious face. It's okay. We're too tired for pleasantries. Just tell us.
It wasn't just an outbreak at one theater.
Uh-oh.
I got stuff going down at multiple locations.
Shit.
How much do you want?
Only what I need.
Okay. He never wants the full story.
It's someone from the screen doing what comes naturally.
And we have no way of stopping the demon from tampering with the audiences, so...
Use the D word again.
Sorry.
Call me.
Thanks, Daryl.
I know where he's gonna be tonight. Every time we leave for a new city, he goes there too.
You mean he's traveling in the print?
We just burned the print.
We can't kill him in our world, so we'll have to do it in his.
Or are we going into the movies?
You mean go into the movie?
You're back! Just in time. Rock company.
Yeah, oh, not...
Billy, how could
I'm
you?
I'm not cheating on you.
We were going steady.
These people, they're here to help us.
Phoebe, do you have the potion?
Oh, couldn't you at least have made it look like it tasted good?
Minty fresh. Hey, it works for him.
Check me out. I'm retro.
And now for the violent climax.
Oh, this guy. Dude, get out of here.
Yeah. Sleep tight, film boy.
Didn't anybody ever tell you what happens once the movie ends if you're still in it?
Remember in the... Hey, you both did. Remember in the... With the photography guy in the basement, she accidentally burned something. I feel like that's gonna link in, don't you? We can burn this guy. But why can't Bart burn Billy? And the girl he's going steady with. We just selectively like... Because Prue's in the real world now, so she has access to the film reel. But, we can't burn Piper and Phoebe either. So maybe I don't know if this plan is going to go well. Hey, what's this whole throw Bloody Mary out a window thing? Why did I say that? When she came into the bathroom, throw her out the window? Why did that? I've never seen a Bloody... I don't even know if there are Bloody Mary movies. That's crazy. This episode it's just hilarious.
Prue, why is it getting dark?
The movie's ending. Prue, up to the projectionist room. Oh, she astral projected up to the projection room. That's funny. She's an astral projectionist.
Get out of there quick.
Run away, little witches.
How does it feel to finally know someone you can't defeat?
You tell me. You know, if you leave a subject under the light for too long, it burns.
Thanks for waking me up to warn me about the film burning. I could have lost my job.
No problem, dude. Phoebe, you gonna say goodbye to...
I guess it's only fair.
Billy?
Thank you for restoring my faith in the male species.
Oh. See you later. Don't worry, a real person will. There's plenty of real people in the world. Aw, jeez. Hey, Dan. Is he returning something?
Hello, door's open.
Is it her stuff?
Some of the things that you left over at my house. I kept them around because part of me was hoping that maybe that you'd come back. And after last night, I realized that I have to move on too.
Hey! Are you...
Just leaving.
Does it never get any easier? I will never see another horror movie again, but I ran across this and thought, oh, Prue,
I love it.
I love it. I'm going to go watch it right now. Should we worry?
Nah. She'll be okay next episode.
And as long as I'm with you, everything's going to be A-okay.
You're my hero, Billy.
And I think you're swell, Sally Mae.
See ya, Billy. That's it. What an episode. So, that was an odd episode from start to finish. It really had me off balance at the beginning. I thought more things were going on than were actually going on in the end. Just an illusion demon. A demon who lived in the movies. Someone who could pass between the real world and the fictional world. Maybe he originally started out in the movies, in the fictional world, and he was so powerfully written that he was able to magic himself out of the fictional world into the real world. You know? Although I think canonically he's just a demon who hitches a ride on film reels and goes from place to place. That's where they're going to get you, though. That's where they're going to get you. And they set it up earlier in the episode. Good attention to detail. And it's good when they leave a little clue in earlier in the episode that they can use at the end to outsmart the bad guy. Phoebe finally has an episode where she's got a romantic interest in somebody. But it's hilarious that it's somebody like that who doesn't really exist. Maybe it's a metaphor for her relationship so far. That she only lets herself fall for the people she knows she won't have to have a long-term relationship with. Same thing with Clay, by the way. Clay's a bit of a... He ain't gonna stay around for long. Is Clay with his feats. Whatever happened to that guy, actually, at the end of that episode? Did you just go back to Egypt and start stealing other things that aren't haunted? A bit of a parallel this episode with Phoebe and Prue. Prue became a photographer, or at least was heavily inspired by somebody as a child. Grew up adoring this photographer guy. Phoebe grew up watching Billy's movies. Funny that it's the Billy the character and not the actor who plays Billy that Phoebe has a crush on, you know? Usually it's, oh, I've got a crush on this actor from this TV show or movie, and not a crush on the character they play. It's an interesting, just a little nuance there. But yeah, they both get to meet their childhood heroes. One is a positive, Billy. The other is a negative in that douche camera guy. He didn't even lighten up a bit. He didn't even soften towards her when she started. I thought when she started showing him a piece of her mind, he'd be like, you know, you're not so bad. But his whole purpose was just for her to think of a way to beat the demon, sort of. Also to sort of put Prue in the position she'd been in regularly throughout this show so far, where her job is the worst part of her life, where there's always stress, it's never smooth sailing with her work environment. There's always a deadline, there's always a troublesome client, there's always something going on. or raise $1 million by tomorrow or you're out of here. Jeez, Claire. Anyway, why can't she just have a nice, chill photography job that doesn't require, you know, bad stuff? Phoebe's got it right. You know, it's always positive stuff with her, even in this episode. But yeah, I thought the episode was going a weird way, like several layers weirder than it actually was, because of the way it started. It started weirdly, and they even commented on how weird it was that things happened straight away and we obliterated them straight away, and I thought there might be something weird going on with time, but then we went straight to Piper and Leo's date. That was also a little bit weird. Desserts were coming first, and I was like, what's going on here? But that was just to have an awkward date night with Dan also there, with that girl who's just from work. Oh, we get to hate her. I've forgotten her name already. That just shows you how much I hate her, that girl. What do you mean, Dan, you were holding her stuff just in case she'd come back? If you were pining over Piper, you're not rebounding with this girl straight away, are you? Can't have it both ways. It's very clear, though, that they're not going to get back together. So his days are still numbered. I put his days at like 5 or something, or 4, if I was to number them. Daryl was in the episode a little bit. He didn't do much. He just showed up for the story, and for so that they could tell him stuff, and he'd be like, "What are you using that word for? Demon." You know, but the horror elements of the movie or the episode were just really comical. They weren't played for scares, they were played for laughs, with the girl screaming and running around a house and hiding in a bath. Just the whole atmosphere of it was just camp horror humor. And Billy throwing himself at the villains, oh, they can't get me. I like the idea that they die the way they died in the movie, because they're playing to a script. They're like, oh shit, this is how I'm supposed to die, okay. Yep. And the people at the movie theater. Oh, I'll throw my popcorn again. I shouldn't joke, because one of them actually died, but maybe it was the Axe Man. What was he? Axe Husband? Oh, what a name. I thought The Exorcist was perfect. You know, I don't know if it makes sense, but that's what I would have called it. Yeah, so let's put this episode under G for goofy. It was just goofy through and through. Phoebe's heart has opened a little chink. Cupid opened it. And then she is dipping her toe in with fictional people. Maybe she'll find someone who isn't fictional. At some point. Maybe not in this season. Maybe in season 3. We're going to have her true love. maybe. Maybe. Yeah, so I had fun. It was a fun episode. Nothing too deep to analyze or talk about. Just fun camp horror humor. And it wasn't set at Halloween or anything. It was like middle of April, I think, this was released. So, yeah. We'll see how open Phoebe's heart is next episode. We'll see if Prue is under any pressure from her workplace. We'll see if Piper and Leo can finally get an uninterrupted date. But them just sitting on the sofa, that's much better. What I was going to say is that We don't need Leona suit. We don't need them all dressed up. Just them chilling out and chatting, lying next to each other. That's it. That's the ideal. Those are the moments you remember. Those are the moments that make a relationship. Not this. Organ guy when you're, you know. That's what I think. Anyway, I will see you next time for episode 19. Have a great day wherever you are. Until then, I'll see you next time.